As the son of a sailor, I went out on the sea for adventure, expanding the view of the captain and crew like a man just released from indenture. As a dreamer of dreams and a traveling man, I have chalked up many a mile, read dozens of books about heroes and crooks, and I learned much from both of their styles. Son of a son, son of a son, son of a sailor, son of a gun, load the last ton, one step ahead of the jailer. Now way in the near future, southeast of disorder, you can shake the hand of the mangled man as he greets you at the border. And the lady, she hails from Trinidad, island of the spices, salt for your meat and cinnamon sweet, and the rum is for all your good vices. Haul the sheet in as we ride on the wind that our forefathers harnessed before us.
It's been very interesting to watch them grow into this thing. So I stole a little bit from some commercial I've heard before, because I really do think you're a very interesting person. In fact, you might be the most interesting man in the world. In fact, he's so interesting that his charm is so contagious, vaccines have been created for it. In fact, Siri asks him for directions. If at first he doesn't succeed, then it's impossible. In fact, I heard his mother has a tattoo that says, son.
Lighten up.
And this one I made up on my own. I think he's the reason that God rested on day 7.
Oh, I can vouch for that. I love it.
You know, I always thought you looked that old.
All right, well, why don't we do this? Why don't we go around, everybody stand up and roast me one at a time with one thing.
All right.
One thing.
Eddie, you're up.
Hey. I need, like, some creative ideas.
You got nothing. I'm awesome.
Okay. No.
Serious laugh.
What is what?
I've never actually used it. I go, well, it ain't a bird scarer, you know. You gotta start using it. So my roast is, this guy never knew anything about radar. He had it on his mind for 2 years and, like, never used it.
Shame. Unless there's fog, I don't turn mine off. I'm not like one of those.
But you've turned it on in the past.
No, in the fog. But I'm not one of those guys in the harbor where the radar is going and I'm like, you see all the things.
Susan, you're up.
You have the cutest drunk smile I've ever seen in my life. I don't know if that's a roast, but...
There it is.
The cutest drunk smile.
There
wow.
It is.
All right.
All right. Yeah. Richard!
Yeah. Okay, all right. How do you know you have a respected Commodore? You know you have a respected Commodore when half the club decides to sail into a hurricane with it. Into a hurra-freaking-cane, okay? And I was a little nervous about that, really, because I've never actually sailed in a hurricane before. Saw the captain earlier. He was next to me at the urinal. And I thought, well, here's a chance to, you know, set my mind at ease. I said, hey, Captain, how often does a ship like this sink? Does it sink often? And he looked at me and said, no, it'll only sink once.
All right, I got one.
So just pretend this is a martini glass. We're on Zoom.
You got 5 minutes to talk. Vinny, what do you got to talk about tonight? Okay. It's your turn, Ed. What do you got to talk about? Sherry, get me another one. I'm empty. Dave, what language are you speaking in? I don't understand. Membership's great, great, great. Don't talk. Sarah, it's your turn. All I want is a buzzer. So every time, so one night I said, Mindy can have my 5 minutes. I got nothing to say. And he goes, all right, Mindy, what do you got to say? Nope. We never get to talk. We try.
I know.
We try, but there's mine.
Good job.
Wow. That's a time shift.
I remember one time I said, I'm going to be more than 5 minutes. And I felt like, oh my gosh. I was going to get the look, you're on a stage in the.
Let's go, Steve. You got anything to say? You want to bring it up right now?
No.
I didn't think so.
Steve has food in front of him. He's focused.
I'm going to put Mike in that same boat. Tommy, you got something to say?
I said my piece.
He already did it.
My wife's got one.
We started. What
about Bob?
You know a good wine, but above what Bob, about you know Bob? A good wine. What about Bob? Great choice with this girl.
How did you do that?
Yes, the right. Best.
At this moment, I'd like to skip over Bob.
No. Bob has known the Commodore for what, 4 hours?
Maybe.
And I have way too many stories. Next year.
Maybe you got something you want to get out off your.
I love you.
Vocal cords.
You know what I love? I love that Mike feels like he has to call me all the time. He calls me all the time. I'm like, who calls? Why didn't you just text me?
He's a caller.
I'm like, okay, but I have to answer because it's the Commodore. And the next thing I know, we talk about the time we were in Swallows and I threw my bra up.
Is it?
Wow, yes.
Oh, that's your birthday.
Yeah, that's one of my favorites.
Oh, yeah. There is that.
Eddie, you don't got
all I got to say is, you know, we all know you have a million flaws. You don't pay attention.
You've met my husband.
You've been talking to my wife.
And you don't drink way enough to even be part of the club. But, cheers.
Cheers.
Well, I'm sorry, that drinking part is one of my stories.
Salute.
Just love
you. We're so proud of you.
I know.
And thank you for
excellent job.
Best. Number one, he's a very bad influence on my husband.
What?
He's a very bad influence on my husband. Between the two of them,
I'm easily led.
In Dublin, at least Mike made it for dinner.
You didn't make it to dinner?
No.
It's something to do with 100 proof Jameson.
No.
Oh,
but,
nice.
But I do love Michael because when we drink martinis together, he always lets me have his olives.
Boom.
Aww.
And Sherry doesn't mind.
So thank you for the olives, Michael.
Aww. Especially the blue cheese stuffed ones.
He's
there you go. Well, I would just like to acknowledge my wife, Sherry, for putting up with me this
year.
She told me that I should never do this, ever, because I don't like this kind of stuff.
Speech.
In all honesty, kudos go out to number one, Mindy.
Mindy.
Being able to come up with this last minute type of thing and to actually make it happen. And number two, a huge kudos to Donna.
No, all the kudos to Donna.
It was your idea, but she put it together.
Donna. Okay.
And I'm going to tell you something. If it wasn't for Mike, then none of us would be here right now.
That's right. Don't you forget it.
We will never forget this. So hats off to both of you, Rear Commodore, Vice Commodore. What a fabulous thing you put together.
Red ass.
Bravo.
Behind her back.
And now it's my turn.
My
To the Commodore.
Second off.
To the Commodore.
No, we're not doing that yet.
Not yet.
Okay. First of all, Tom Rizzullo with the membership chair.
Woo!
He's put everything together.
Best
everybody here is on the board. And these are the people that have made this whole year happen. Our JAG has put together things that we have never done before since I've been a member here, even though it's only 2.5 years.
Yeah, yeah, that wasn't very long.
You've been a member for 2.5 years? Yeah.
David and Monique. For David pulled me in a long time ago, and without his guidance, I would not have understood what all this is about.
Wait, he's been a member for 2.5 years.
Everybody here, Ed has given us guidance through a lot of things that we've asked and that we had questions on, and he came up with all the answers. Why am I holding a knife?
Just in case.
I'm not concerned about the wine you're waving around.
So everybody here makes this happen, and I think everybody needs to give us a round of applause.
What
except
about
for Bob.
Steve and the Pinnacle?
I'm just scared to be the odd man out.
What makes this so much fun and what makes this happen and everybody makes it like fun is Steve, our guy that does the Pinnacle and
the
pictures.
Yeah.
Yeah. I look back since I was able to look back.
Take your pictures.
He has all the Pinnacles on the website. I look back and gosh, look at where they've come to where they are now.
Yeah.
It's so much fun to look at. I sent it to my kids and my sister and they love reading it.
Yeah.
Steve, you do a fantastic job. Absolutely fantastic job. Thank you all for being here tonight, except for Steve.
And,
sorry, Bob.
I'm the only guy that's been here less than he has.
I'm going to tell you something right now. The guy I've drank most with tonight is Bob. And last but not least, our secretary. She's going to drive this whole force forward.
Am I?
The JAG has put together, the secretary is going to drive this thing forward. To Mindy, carry it forward and be strong. We love you.
To the Commodore.
Cheers!
Said, doctor, ain't there nothing I can take? I said, doctor.
get this straight. Put the lime in the coconut, you drank a boat up. Put the lime in the coconut, you drank a boat up. Put the lime in the coconut, you drank a boat up. Put the lime in the coconut, you called your doctor, woke him up, said, doctor, ain't there nothing I can take? I said, doctor, to relieve his bellyache. I said, doctor, ain't there nothing I can take? I said, doctor. Lime in the coconut and call me in the morning.